you're going to see how to fill and adjust the parameters of the fluid with this example. To do this, the first thing will be to create an emitter, which in this case is circular, and adjust it within the geometry of the bottle so that the fluid leaves from there. Once it has been adjusted, we assign a RealFlow collider tag for the geometry of the bottle and the surface. When we simulate, we can see that the simulation is not right. This is because we must adjust the geometry of the collision for the bottle. Selecting the collider tag for the geometry of the bottle, we must activate the parameter Show Collision Geometry and simulate to see this geometry collision. We can see that then the geometry of the bottle is not right and we must adjust it within the parameters of the object of the collider tag, modifying the cell size and surface offset parameters. The geometry of the collision has been adjusted. It is important that the collision is not shown in the simulation time, since it increases the duration. We increase the resolution and simulate. We can see that the simulation is improved, but there are particles escaping from the geometry of the bottle. Selecting the collider tag for the geometry cube, we introduce some friction and see that we don't want bouncing when the particles collide. We are going to establish a greater resolution and the SPH solver. Simulate, we can see that the particles are no longer going through the geometry of the bottle. Using the PBD solver, the particles are going through because the steps needed for the simulation are greater than those set by default. However, for the SPH, there is a range set from 1 to 300, which RealFlow calculates, taking into account if it needs more steps or not. If we assign more steps for the PBD solver, we will prevent the particles going through the geometry. We must take into account that increasing the number of steps also increases the duration of the simulation. Or in this case, the PBD solver could cause the fluid to be unstable. As a final step, we are going to create a mesh, adding a RealFlow mesher and adjust the parameters.